Welcome to No Clue, No Stress. My name is Heidi Kanzer, and today it's time to explain cycling pads in a very simple way. To answer all the questions we have about cycling pads, I'll be joined by Mr. Leonardo Bortolato of Dr. Pat. Dr. Pat is an Italian company specialized in producing one of the best cycling pads in the market. Hello and welcome to our show. How are you today?
Hello, I'm fine. What about you, Heidi?
Very great. Thank you so much. I'm looking forward to get some answers from you. So the first question that I have is, what is a basic specific of a woman specific pad?
If we compare men and women pads, the materials are maybe the same. So we will go to the shape. Women has a different distance between the sit bones in the average statistics, and also they have a different shape in the perineal part. So the shape we make on the pad is definitely the main and more important difference between male and female.
What about the thickness?
Well, the thickness is something which is probably more similar, at least on the sit bone. So on the back part, you will have the maximum support in both male and female pads. On front, it depends on the shape. So if on male, you will have two lateral parts which are more padded and maybe a little lag on the center. The female pad will be more even, maybe a little less padded, but more evenly the foam will be distributed.
Which part of the woman-specific pad is the most important, that it's made well and that it's made from good materials?
The fabric is very important to prevent fungus or bacteria act in a bad way with the mucosa and the skin. So that is probably something to really care about. So we have developed a fabric specifically with a fabric supplier, which is a polyester with a wicking treatment called Ultra Dry that allows the moisture to be removed from the skin and to keep a better balance of humidity on the surface of the skin.
How to recognize a badly or a shabbily made pad?
This is a difficult thing to understand. I mean, probably everybody will recognize a too soft insert, so they will discard it from the beginning. But if the pad is well padded, it has nice shapes, it looks good, it's difficult to say if it's actually a good pad, I mean, with a good performance, or it is just a good looking pad. So the ultimate way to understand it is to try it. I'm sorry, because there are a lot of pads on the market, a lot of garments, and probably looking at their website, the clothing manufacturer's website will help the most advanced brands usually have a page dedicated to the explanation for their pad. This can give something more, some more information, some more hints to have a better decision. But as I said, the ultimate test is to trial it.
Okay, so you can go wrong.
It is experience, after all. It's also something personal. I mean, there's no the perfect pad for everybody. Everyone has his own specific needs, and so to trial is the best way to go through the decision. And when you find it, when you find the right pad, stick to it.
Can a wrongly chosen pad cause genital pain, or can it be the cause of the pain while riding?
Absolutely. The performance, the quality of the pad, and also the positioning, so the installation of the pad, are really crucial And of course, if they are not made in a good way, that they will 100% cause some pain or problems.
Can it mean that I can definitely not ride my bike with a triathlon pad if the design of the pants is so likable to me that I would really want those pants?
So on road biking, you will have a balanced support on the back and on the front, because you will have time where you sit more upright and time in your ride when you are more lean forward. About triathlon, you are usually in an aero position, so you will have the most of the support on the front part of the pad. On the other side, you need to swim in the first stage of your race, so the pad has also to be really small, because more foam means more water absorption. And so there are some difference between the activities and consequently on the pad.
Choose a pad that is supposed to last for 2 hours. I can definitely not ride it for free.
Usually it is something less impactant on the shape of the pad. We can maybe work on the density of the foam, so you will have lighter foams for shorter rides. This would also allow to have a lighter and more breathable pad if you aim to ride only for a couple hours, and you would go with a heavier and more supportive foam if you go for a 7-8 hour ride. But in the end, if you have a supportive foam, you can use it and find your comfort also on shorter rides. So if you only have one bullet to shot, you will certainly go for the more supportive foam.
So what is the usual lifespan of a pad?
I usually say that 1 to 2 years, if you have an average usage of the garment. You have some different garment to use, so you can have a rotation, have a good care of the cleaning and the drying of the of your rib shirt is the normal life of the pad. I know that the fabric of the rib shirt will last longer, so you can always, not always actually, but in most of the cases, you can replace the pad on your bib shirt. So when you find out that the pad is worn, you can just renew the life of your bib shirt, replacing the pad.
How well can actually a pad be washed according that it's made of this thick foam?
The foam, which is the main material used for the padding, the water and the rain and the sweat are the main enemies for the sponge. So to have a good care of the pad when washing them and cleaning them is the one of the main thing to let the pad last long.
Should we squeeze it with hands or just put it in the washer? What's the best?
With no problem, wash them like you wash every other sport clothing you have. So synthetic, squeeze them gently just to let the water, the excessive water to come out, and dry them gently as well. The gentler you are, the longer they will last.
Is it a smart decision to do to buy used bib?
If you think that you sit directly without your underwear on the pads, to me personally it is difficult. I won't personally buy a used garment. Maybe if I had the possibility to change the pad, I give it a thought, but not in general.
What was your advice when it comes to really buying a new pair of shorts or choosing the right pad for anybody?
Information is the main thing. go on the blogs, on the website of the producer, even call the companies.
Would you say that it's at least a little bit more safe to buy a pair of shorts that which also contain a tag or a label of the pad they are using?
Marketing people know that this is something the final users look at. So some manufacturers don't want to don't want the final user to know the source of their products. I would be happy to have my name on their garment, but if you call me, I will tell you definitely based on where you are calling from to give you advice on where you can find something of our production.
So you are offering a kind of a hotline for pet productions. We'll just put down if you want.
Yeah, no, if you can put the hotline on,
I will.
Video.
So thank you very much for answering these questions to me. It was a real pleasure.
And my pleasure as well. Thank you for asking me to do that.
Thank you for watching. If you like the show, make sure you click subscribe. We have some other great content incoming, so make sure you don't miss it.